You guys, this week is Halloween, so come with us and let's check out some costumes. Where do you care for me when we all fall asleep? Where do we go?
Say it, spit it out. This one here.
Francesca! No, Frank! Today I'm thinking about things that are guilty. The way I'm drinking you down,
like I wanna jump, like I wanna end me. Step on the glass. Okay, let's just have some beers. I need a shot, honestly, so I can relax a bit.
Yeah.
Okay, so you guys, something great has come up. There's a guy in town, his name is Charbel. He is a sick DJ and he's throwing a boat party. I didn't think I was gonna be able to get tickets, it's sold out, but I happened to get my hands on one. So I'm going to go with one of my best friends, Yanina and Kirsten, and let's see what happens.
Why you decided to come to Australia?
Yeah, I came here for a 2-week vacation.
Yeah?
My best friend, her mom had committed suicide.
Really? But before you come or here?
Yeah, before I had come.
Yeah.
And my dad had died the year before, so both of us were thinking, oh, maybe it's better to go somewhere for Christmas. So really? We just booked like a 2-week vacation and we came to Australia because the flights were cheap. So we came to Australia. First few days I didn't really like it, but then I fell in love with the people. I was in the airplane.
Yeah.
And
really, you get in the airplane?
Yeah, to go back home after my vacation, and I was ready to just stand up and stay.
Yeah.
But I went home, packed up my things, and yeah, I flew back here like 2 or 3 weeks later. And then I started working just at some little restaurants and everything. And I ended up being the personal assistant for a property manager.
Yeah.
And he owns Noah's. So then I started working at Noah's and slowly became, the general manager.
You have some
regrets?
Yeah?
No.
No way.
It's been the most amazing experience of my whole life.
Nice.
I wish everybody who is sitting at home feeling lonely could come have an experience like this where you feel loved by everyone. Everyone has a place. Yeah, it's been amazing. Guilty at times because I know we're literally living in paradise, but working where I live and with the same people, sometimes I really feel like I need a bit of an escape. So we decided today to rent a boat. We went out in the ocean. I was so nervous. It was my first time that I ever actually drove the boat by myself. And there was so much traffic in Sydney Harbor, but we made it. We're safe. Hopefully I get my damage deposit back. And yeah, it was great. Honestly, after spending all week in Bondi, it's so nice to be away. For the moment with before the night, yeah, wake up in the morning, vomit all on the walls. When she got the munchies, she know who she gon' call.
Yeah, ready?
Yeah.
Dylan, tell us the biggest, weirdest thing what happened in NOAS since you're here in Australia.
That's really hard. There's so much fucked up shit that has happened. I honestly, I can't even count. Just like iconic people. Somebody took a fucking shit in the stairs outside your door. And
shit, like
a shit, a big shit.
Like a big poo.
Me out of that.
When?
Oh my god. How?
And so I just went around and told everyone. It was one person, I thought, but I have no evidence. I don't know who did it. Yeah, I just went around and told everyone.
You don't know?
I have no idea who it was. I said, oh, it's Baptiste.
The camera didn't get it.
No.
It was so bad. Like in NOAS, I don't know, I feel like everyone who comes there stays longer.
Yeah.
As I like, it's a Bondi bubble, and everyone is like, stay 1 week and then extend for another week and another week, and then it's like 3 months gone, and then it's like grows to such a family. And I know a lot of people say, oh, farm work is like, I met my family, blah blah blah. Well, I never did farm work, but I can literally say NOAS is like, you meet family there. Yeah. Like, you meet people, you see 100% again in life. I think that makes NOAS so special.
I love to, like, you can literally be any way you want. You can be the most different type of person, anything, and you are accepted and literally loved for who you are. This is incredible. I hope you enjoy coming out in Sydney Harbour with us today, and I would love if you subscribe down below and wait and see what happens next week.